Woo! Music sounded good. All right, here we go. A little Michael Jackson to kick us off. Welcome everyone. Woo! I feel like turning up a little bit. Gotta straighten up your act and boogie down. Pull somebody out of here. Come on. If you can't ain't get the feeling, then there ain't no room for you in this part. It's a big time celebration. Everybody, get ready. A little warm up music. Come on inside the room. West Tennessee Community College is your best choice. Come on. And just enjoy yourself. Groove. Let the madness and the music get to you. Like things so bad at all. Oh, yeah, we're feeling the music right now. Those of you who go back with me like Michael Jackson, big time fans. Here we go. Woo! Faculty and staff awards recognition about to go down. Come on in the room. We're ready. Come on. If you know the words, sing. Tonight. Woo! That's what we're going to do today, enjoy ourselves and have a good time. Southwest Tennessee Community College. Faculty and staff, a big awards recognition for those who deserve it. Come on. I'm going to crank it up a little bit. Take it to the bridge. Come on. Woo. Come on, it's time. Yay. Come on in the room. Let's go. Woo. I come up a little bit later on in the pre-warm-up. I'm going to have some trivia questions for you. I want to know how many of y'all know your music like I do. So get ready. Better do it now before you get too old. Woo. Why? Because we're the party people night and day. Living crazy, that's the only way. So tonight, gotta leave the 9 to 5 up on the shelf. And just enjoy yourself. Come on. Here we go. Here we go. Sing it again. Get ready. Come on, everybody. I'm going to leave that 9 to 5 up on the shelf. Woo. And just enjoy yourself. Yeah, come on. Yeah. Let the madness in the music get to you. Oh, yeah. I'm loving this. Woo. Let me put this in the mix for you. For your feet, come on. We behind the scenes doing it right now for you. Come on in the lunch pool. Come on. Oh yeah. Woo! Good morning, everybody. If you're in here, come on in. Stan Bell serving you well and pushing more power than a Duracell. That's what's up. Woo! Ronda Warren in the building. Hey! Come on. Oh yeah. Gotta say congratulations to all our honorees, all our award recipients. I'm gonna be shouting your names out in just a little bit, so make sure you come on in the room and be ready for it. I got you. Southwest Tennessee Community College. Woo! We're in the month of July. Shout out to anybody born in the month of July. You celebrate just like Southwest, for real. Woo! What a legacy. State Technical Institute. And Shelby State. Let me tell you what I say. Woo-hoo! Come on. 21st Century College, everybody. You know how we get down. Woo! Greater than the sum of its parts. Southwest Tennessee Community College. We're in the mix. Come on, let's go. Back in the day, we used to call this Pig Latin. We used to sing it backwards. It made a little bit of sense. Come on. We used to call it Pigland. Hey! Come on. We behind the scenes. Come on. The Double Gazette. Woo! Oh, yeah. It's a beautiful Friday morning. We're getting down with the get down. Double Dutch Bus. Come on, Frankie Smith. Let's go. Oh, yeah. Come on. This is a Z. Here we go. You like this old school? Just got to put your hands together right here. You like that old school? Say, yeah. Come on. Southwest is now the second largest community college in Tennessee. Board of Regents system and the second largest college in Memphis. My hometown, the Bluff City. The city of good abode. That's how we get down. I love this music. Come on. Woo-wee. More than 10,000 students per year. Come on. Bip-bop-bam. Yeah. Alakazam. Yay. But
only if you're grooving with the Double Dutch Man. Put on your skates.
Come on.
Don't forget,
your rope. Cause I know now, those of you already in the lunch pool in the room, you may remember some of this from the skate rink back in the day. Come on. You got to be over 35 to know this song right here. Come on.
Mills Harbor, Mills Harry, Mills Eddie, Mills Sam.
Skating rink.
Mills Army, Mills.
Woo. Mills. Shout out to Dr. Tracy Hall, the college's first female president in the building. Congratulations, Dr. Hall. You're doing an excellent job. Let's go. Woo. Here we go. In the mix. Let's go. Woo-wee. Yeah, how we doing? Come on in the room. Go back a little bit. Oh, yeah. Hopefully you're loving what you hear. We're going back. Woo! Southwest Tennessee Community College. Today has over 800 employees, including 150 full-time faculty members. All right, come on, sing the song. Here we go. Come on, talk about it. This is the part I love right here, y'all. Woo! Here we are! Woo! Come on! It's a virtual celebration. July 24, it's going down. 2020, Southwest Tennessee Community College. It's your best choice. Come on! Congratulations, let's go. We're celebrating a merger, a birth, if you will. State Technical Institute at Memphis and Shelby State, woo, 20 years ago. Come on. Come on, Sir Lucas, come on in the room, Sir Lucas, come on. Yeah. Got a song you want to hear in the mix, get in the chat box. You get in the chat box, get some conversation going, come on in the room. I will play what you say in the mix. You keep it old school. Hey! Put your request in the chat box, or if you got my personal text, you can text it to the bell ringer. You can do it. What's up, Mark Thompson? You can do it. Text me if you need something. Anybody, your request. Come on. Put it up in the chat box. I got you. This is what I like. I see you in the room, Dr. Hall. I see you. Come on. Talk about. All right, come up in about 60 seconds. I got some trivia I want you to take care of for me. If you like music like I do, I want to know if you can answer the following questions. Coming up in just a little bit. Get ready. Put your thinking caps on. Woo! And get with somebody at the table that loves music. Woo! All right, check it out. I got my first question. I'm ready. If you're ready, say yay. Which pop star played 27 different instruments on their debut album? And the album was titled For You. All right, let me ask the question again. Which pop star played 27 different instruments on their debut album? And the album was titled For You. If you think you know the answer, put it in the chat box. Shout it out to everybody at the table. If you know it, don't keep it to yourself. Let me know. I'm going to give you the answer coming up in 20 seconds. You get it? 20 seconds. That's the number. Woo! Come on. Yay! Come on. You got it?
Won't you take me to...
Okay, the answer to the question, which pop star played 27 different instruments on their debut album? And the album was titled For You. The answer? Prince. Hey! You got it? All right. Come on. You got the answer is Prince. He is the man in my book forever and a day. I got a couple of more questions for you coming up. Keep it right here as we celebrate 20 years, Southwest Tennessee Community College. Woo! All right, next question. Come on, next question, everybody. Who won Top R&B Male Artist at the Billboard Music Awards back in 2018? Who won Top R&B Male Artist at the Billboard Music Awards back in 2018? If you know the answer, talk it over to make sure you got it right with everybody at your table as we get ready to kick off the celebration. I need to know the name of the artist. Come on, think about it. Let's go. Woo! Yay! You may remember this song while you're thinking it over, all right? Little Aretha Franklin. Aretha Franklin. Come on, jump to it.
Jump to it.
Coming up in 60 seconds, I got the answer to the second trivia question. Found out if you're batting 1,000 so far. It's a party on a beautiful Friday morning. Come on.
My baby loves me.
Hey.
He told me that.
Come on.
And I never.
It's answer time. It's also party time. But I got to give you the answer. I think you're smart about this one.
There is no fight.
Who won Top R&B Male Artist at the Billboard Music Awards back in 2018? I think you know. And the answer is Bruno Mars. Hey! Come on. If you got that right, I want you to kind of wave back at me. Just wave at me. If you got that right at your table, whoever, if you knew it, come on. That's right. Bruno Mars, that's what I like. Come on. Woo. 24/7. 24 karat magic. I come up the next 30 seconds. While you sip on that water that you have right now, I'm going to drop another trivia question. And I'm going to give you a hint in advance. It's going to have something to do with Memphis music. It's going to have something to do with Memphis music. So get ready at your table. Come on. All right, next trivia question. We ready. Next trivia question. If you're from Memphis or you've been here a long time, you might know about this one. The question is, how did the singer Otis Redding die? Now, don't be facetious now. How did Otis Redding die? Yeah. Ooh, okay, while you think about that, shout out to Dominique Brown. Got my question correct. My first question was right, Dominique Brown. And my second winner who got it right, is that Miss Mia?
You know, when we talk, we have a lot of fun, don't we, girl?
Yeah.
Dishing out the dirt on
N-A.
And giving each other the
is that Johnson?
Who drop kick two this week.
Yeah, you know N-A from. Johnson. Not applicable. First name not. Middle, applicable, Johnson, congratulations. Thank you for putting it in the chat box. Yeah, that's right. All right, number three, third question, how did Otis Redding die? If you know the answer, say yay. Come on, I see you in my chat box. Come on. Woo. Jump to it. Yay. And I went up for my third trivia question. It goes to Daphne Thomas. She got it right. Otis Redding perished in the plane crash. That's right. And to be more exact, in Madison, Wisconsin, Otis Redding, remember the Barclays? Yeah. Oh, yeah. Thank you, Daphne. Congratulations. You got it, girl. I got another question. Come on. We're playing music trivia. Southwest Tennessee Community College with your host, Stan Bell, your pre-warm-up show DJ. Let's go. Let me get back in the mix while you're jammed. We mixing, y'all. I'm ready for my fourth question. If you ready for the fourth music trivia question, say yay! Well, you better take your time and do this one right. Let's do it. Hey! All right, Quattro. Michael Jackson fans. I know you're gonna eat this one up. I know if you got any Michael Jackson fans, kind of wave your hand to me. Just wave it back at me. All right, here's the question. Michael Jackson's Thriller was produced by what? Producer, megastar. Oh, you know that was Sister Rhonda. Michael Jackson's album Thriller was produced by the great who? Rhonda Warren trying to answer. I see you in the chat box. She's spelling and typing fast in the chat box. Go ahead, Sister Warren. I got the answer coming up. In 20 seconds, in keeping with Southwest Tennessee Community College 20th celebration. Shelby State Community College, State Technical Institute in Memphis. I'm playing so hard, y'all gonna make me come out this suit in a minute. The answer is the one and only Quincy Jones. Did you get it right? If you got it right, say yay. You got it right. I see you. Keep typing away. I got a couple more questions. Get ready. Let me get back to the mix while you're doing that. And shout out the correct answer, of course, Otis Redding, and the winner, Dominique Brown. What can Brown do for you? UPS, baby. Congratulations. You know your music history and your trivia. Otis Redding, sitting on the dock of the bay. Now, in keeping with that same question, can you name for me the survivor of that awful plane crash? Can you tell me the sole survivor from that plane crash? Come on, that's your trivia question right now. On that fateful day in Madison, Wisconsin, when that plane crashed in that cold body of water, there was a survivor. Give me the name right now while I put this in the mix. Ooh, I got requests coming in at the Yin Yang. Come on, I got you. Okay, so the answer, do we have anybody in the chat box? I'm gonna give you just a few more seconds to put your answer. Who was the sole survivor in that fateful plane accident in Madison, Wisconsin that took the life of Otis Redding and others? Somebody made it. Come on, somebody was rescued. Tell me who it was. You got it? Miss Rhonda, you know that one? That's old school, right? You gotta be at least 40 to know about that. Come on, everybody. I see the answers coming in. Here comes your answer. I'm getting ready. And then I'm going to go straight to the request line. Somebody wanted to hear Wake Up Everybody. That's a good positive song right there. Harold Melvin and Blue Notes with little Teddy Pendergrass in there. I'm going to do that for Southwest Tennessee Community College. Who they are? Come on. Okay, the name of the sole lone survivor of that plane crash that carried the members of the Barclays was Ben Cauley. Ben, let him in, Ben. C-A-U-L-E-Y. He played trumpet for the Barclays. Remember that song? Soul Finger. That was Ben Cauley on that trumpet, baby. High C above the staff. He could play it. Y'all ready? I want to play a request. N.A. Jones got the right answer. N.A. Jones again? He got it right. Boy, you're on a roll. Let me take care of requests. Ooh-wee, straight out the chat box, conversation box. You in the room with your request. Yeah, a little Harold Melvin and the Blue Note Stan Bell. Taking care of your request live on the fly on this beautiful Friday morning. Celebrating with Southwest Tennessee
Wake up
Community
everybody,
College.
No more sleeping in bed. No more back thinking, time for thinking ahead. The world has changed so very much from what it used to be. Woo! There's so much hatred, war and poverty.
Oh, it's the pretty part right here. Come on, y'all.
Wake up all the teachers, time to teach a new way. Maybe then they'll listen to what you have to say. They're the ones who's coming up, and the world is in their hands. When you teach the children, teach them the very best you can.
Here's the part I like right here.
World won't get no better if we just let it be. Change it now, just you and me. Wake up all the doctors, make the old people well.
Keep your requests coming, I see it.
They're the ones who suffer and who catch all the hair.
Yes, sir.
They don't have so bad.
T-minus 9.5 minutes to showtime.
Won't you make them happy before they pass away?
Right on schedule.
Woo!
B2 Media behind the scenes.
It's time to build a new
thank
land.
You so much. Here we go.
I know we could do it if we all lend a hand. The only thing we have to do is put it in our minds.
That's right.
Surely things will.
Your best choice.
They do it every time.
Listen to the lyrics. This is the part right here.
The world won't get no better.
No, it won't.
If we just let it be.
Time for one more request. Come on.
The world won't get no better.
Time for one more request.
We gotta change it.
Just gotta change this thing.
You and me.
Woo! Don't stop the loving this, Sister Rodney. I see the conversation. You want some maze?
Change.
We'll make that maze happen.
Change it, yeah. Just you and me. Change it, yeah. Change it. Can't do it alone. Need some help, y'all.
Woo-wee! All right, you like that? Uh-oh. Here we go.
Whoa, whoa.
It's the request. Virtual, it's about to go down, everybody. The virtual ceremony and celebration for Southwest Tennessee Community College. 20 years in the making, and we don't see any stopping. No time soon. Your request of Maze featuring Frankie Beverly right now.
You made me happy.
Come on.
This you can bear. You stood right beside me.
Yeah.
And I won't forget.
Woo.
And I really love you.
You should know. Thank you, Dr. Hall. I see you jamming over there at your table.
Before I let go.
I see you jamming. Excellent leadership. Thank you so much. Thank you for having me as your MC. We're coming back later to let you know what's up. Woo! Come on.
We've heard in each other.
Come on.
Girl, it's a
shame. Come on. It was back on July 1. July the 1st, 20. Actually, 2000. The merger happened. The legacy of two institutions becoming as one. It's like a marriage. Two becoming as one. Yay!
You know I thank God.
All the married folks, throw your hands up right now. All the married folks, you kind of know where I'm going with this, right? Two becoming as one. It's a love story. Just like this song. Hold this note like Frankie. Hold it, let me hear it.
Go.
I hear you holding that note, Southwest. Come on.
Oh, I would never,
State Technical Institute at Memphis and Shelby State Community College merged 20 years ago. And the good thing about it, they merged into a 21st century institution. that is truly greater than the sun of his power. I applaud you. Come on. Southwest Tennessee Community College. Many of you watching right now receive your degree or certificate, letter of accomplishment from Shelby State, State Tech, and now Southwest Tennessee Community College. Congratulations on the job well done. Nothing like a good education, that's for real. Woo, come on. Big shout to Dr. Nathan Essex, the college's very first president. Yes, he was appointed, and he was anointed too. Hey, come on. Come on, Maze, your request.
I can't let you go.
Woo. Come on.
I can't let you go.
Woo. That's two great requests right there. Yay. Come on, I think I got time for another trivia question while we're in the warm-up. I think I got time. We got 4 minutes. About 4.5 minutes. So I think I got time for one more trivia question. If you're ready for it, just throw it way back at me or type something in the conversation chat box. All right. Woo! All right, here we go. Which song by Katy Perry featuring Snoop Dogg spent 6 weeks at the top of the charts in the United States? Which song by Katy Perry featuring Snoop D-O-double-G spent 6 weeks at the top of the charts on Billboard? All right, you got the answer. Come on, talk to me. Ooh-wee. I need a brick house to answer this one. We got an ass up there. Ooh, we got a jam first though. Can I go old school? You like that one? That's an old school right there. My photog said, I know this one.
Ow, she's a brick.
Which song by Katy Perry featuring the rapper Snoop Dogg spent 6 weeks at the top of the charts on Billboard? I think somebody got an answer. What's the name of that song? We got an answer. Amanda Pruitt said California Girls. That's right. Hold on. She got it right. Everybody betting 1,000. Ooh-wee. To get a man. So what I want to do, check it out. I'm going to give everybody a big hand on this one, all right? Congratulations to all my winners. That's what's up. Come on. Letting it all hang. We behind the scenes. V2 Media and, of course, Stan Bell, the bell ringer, right at you. Coming to you virtually. Live. Come on. Woo. This is not a recording. What you see is what you get. Like Geraldine Flip Wilson. About 2 minutes and counting. 2 minutes and counting. And we're gonna start this party. Dr. J in the building. I see you, Dr. Jaggers. I see you. Come on, Dr. J. Woo! Yeah! With the Staff Awards making it happen. Woo-wee! Come on, break it down. Keep it rolling. All right. Most of you, many of you are tuned in right now. You can text somebody and tell them to get in. Get the code, get the conference ID, do what you got to do, because this is going to be phenomenal and monumental. Stan Bell serving you well and pushing more power than a Duracell. Come on. We're in the mix this morning. Woo! Let me know who else at that table, Dr. J, Dr. Jaggers. What's up, Terrence King? I see you, TK. I don't love you. She typed in, I'm alumnus of Shelby State. I got you. I still remember in the days when I was. While I'm thinking about it, my wife attended State Technical Institute in Memphis. Yes, she did. My lovely wife, Carla Bell, many moons ago. Well, she is smart as all get out. Come on. Woo. Alumni, come on, check in with me today.
A thousand kisses from you is never too much.
I just don't
wanna stop. Oh my love. A million days in your arms is never
too much. All right, ladies and gentlemen, that's nothing like a little Luther Vandross on a beautiful Friday morning. All right, whoo! Let me welcome you to the official staff. Faculty awards ceremony. We are doing it virtually. I'm going to be your agenda guide, your MC, your program navigator. My name is Stan Bell, serving you well and pushing more power than a Duracell. So I want to give a big shout out to the staff and faculty and all the stakeholders of Southwest Tennessee Community College, your best choice. So on behalf of the president, Dr. Tracy D. Hall, that D stands for Dynamo. Want to welcome you, and I want to say personally, thank you for allowing me to be your agenda guy for this morning. Welcome. So with that being said, let's cue up our next person, Miss Rhonda. Let's go straight to the president, Dr. Tracy Hall.
Welcome faculty, staff, and special guests to this first ever virtual Faculty and Staff Award Ceremony. I hope you and your loved ones are well as we navigate our new normal. We are certainly living in difficult times. You cannot turn on the television or read the newspaper without seeing yet another devastating news story or depressing headline. Our world has literally changed in just a few short months. I have to say though, you all have been troopers. What you have accomplished over the past few months is nothing short of amazing. Thanks to you, the college pivoted quickly, changed course, and kept our operations and students moving forward. I am truly proud of you, proud of us. And that, my friends, is reason enough for us to still come together despite the unusual venue to celebrate all that is good and wonderful about Southwest. Today's event is to celebrate those among you who, in the pursuit of our noble mission, have created, innovated, and gone above and beyond the call of duty time and again over the past year. Today's honorees have distinguished themselves as those who never, ever accept the status quo. Instead, they create, reimagine, and always set the bar higher. They bypass mediocrity and doggedly pursue excellence as the only acceptable outcome. It is their beacon, their standard. It is the Southwest way. To the honorees today, I salute you and thank you from the bottom of my heart for your talent and commitment to our mission. You are invaluable members of the college, and your personal and professional commitment to quality is manifested in your efforts each day. I'm so glad you are on our team at Southwest, and thank you for all you do, and congratulations.
Thank you, Dr. Hall. Stan Bell is no stranger to the Mid-South area. He communicates on and off the air daily. He has become one of Memphis's most energetic, beloved radio personalities for over 34 years now. Stan is also a Shelby County Schools career and technology instructor. He currently teaches AV production at Middle College High School at CBU. He began teaching his profession at Northside High School, his alma mater, where he taught English and applied economics. Stan has been teaching with the district since 1993. Stan is a native Memphian and a product of Memphis City Schools, attending High Park Elementary, Valentine, Snowden, Cypress, and Northside High. He received his undergraduate degree in mass communication from UT Martin. He received his master's degree and EDS degrees from Union University in Jackson, Tennessee. Stan is also a member of the Kappa Alpha Psi Fraternity Incorporated, and he is also professionally involved with the Kappa Delta Pi, an international honors organization for educators. Now let's give it up for Stan, the bell ringer.
All right, thank you so much. Rhonda Warren in the house. I feel like doing a roll call. Rhonda's in the house with the roll call. Thank you so much. Rhonda Warren, who is Director of HR Human Resources, in case you didn't know. All right, and you know what? That was a beautiful introduction. But really, I am humbled by that. I always say the two most important words in the language, thank you. Most important, we. Least important, I. I am humbled for this opportunity. Southwest Tennessee Community College, this award ceremony, I am ready, I'm excited. It is truly a celebration. So let's have our presentation of awards, and we're going to celebrate this beautiful Friday morning with our staff and employees. Let's go. Woo!
Hi, Southwest family. I'm Bridget Johnson, interim president of Say So. And I'm here to announce the organization's Say So Awards of Excellence, criteria for Support Staff Excellence Awards, the Kenneth W. Mathis Environmental Service Award. The employee has to have at least 2 years of service to the college. Excellence is exemplified by the following criteria: demonstrating exceptional campus service values through safety, courtesy, and quality performance, exhibiting ways of making campus life better, which will have a positive impact on the lives of students, staff, faculty, and administration, exhibiting demeanor that goes beyond the established qualification of the office and environmental service personnel, demonstrating a warm and caring attitude towards all individuals. This is for physical plant staff only. This individual follows the rules and guidelines that are given, and she's a professional custodian. Her time served, she's completed all of her environmental online trainings on time, and she has learned to operate the floor machines with no problem. She is very consistent in her work, and she does not have a problem helping any other staff. And that person is none only than Sony C. Motley. Congratulations, Sony, for winning the Kenneth W. Mathis Award. To announce our next award, Support Staff Professional Growth Award. This employee has to have at least 2 years of service with college. Excellence is exemplified by the following criteria: improving on job skills, showing evidence of lifelong learning, improving leadership skills by participating in activities will benefit the college, seeking opportunities to improve interpersonal and communication skills, demonstrating commitment to further the mission of the college. That individual has been seen helping others that just happened in the office that was actually looking for another office. And after making phone calls, she ended up taking that individual, walking them to where they actually needed to be. She challenges herself and she's not afraid to take on something new or unfamiliar. She finds and attends all the webinars that she can to enhance her knowledge here within Southwest. And that person is none other than Monica C. Crawford. Congratulations, Monica. You are the Support Staff Professional Growth Award winner. Now it's time for the next award, Support Staff Service Award. This employee has to have at least 3 years of service to the college. Excellence is exemplified by the following criteria: demonstrating above average work skills, producing quality work, communicating with supervisor, fellow workers, and the public in a manner which exemplifies respect for supervision, showing consideration of others in the workplace, and friendliness towards colleagues, exhibiting commitment to the college through acts of service. That individual has been known to organize and arrange the selection of the angel tree for the department that she works in each year. She also serves our VA students by picking up snacks and supplies whenever needed. She is very pleasant, patient, soft-spoken, and her disposition is approachable. And if you meet her, she will leave an impression. That person is none other than Miss Edna Claxton. Congratulations, Edna, on winning the Support Staff Service Award. Now, to the biggest award, our Support Staff Employee of the Year Award. The employee has to have at least 5 years of service to the college. Excellence is exemplified by the following criteria: demonstrating the superior job knowledge and performance. And that person is currently working on her bachelor's degree at the University of Memphis. She commits to working extended hours whenever needed in the office. She is professional, dependable, responsible, honest, self-motivated, positive, and encouraging. She has good work ethics. She has the initiative to do what is needed, not only for academic affairs, but with a great consideration for the students. This person has started out with the college in admissions and records as a records clerk. She moved on to graduation analyst, and now she serves as the course scheduling specialist. Congratulations, Bernice Jackson. You are Southwest Support Staff Employee of the Year. We thank all of you for the great work and everyone out there for their great work. Thank you.
Hello, I'm Katrina Muldrow, President of PASO.
And I am Rhonda Warren, Vice President of PASO.
Each year, the Professional Administrative Staff Organization recognizes and celebrates the outstanding achievements and meritorious service of its members nominated by its peers. The categories for the awards are for leadership and service.
On behalf of the PASO Executive Committee, we would like to first take the moment to thank everyone who took the time to submit nominations. We received numerous nominations from every division, so thank you. We were so delighted to review each of them as they highlighted the wonderful work demonstrated by those who were nominated in each category.
Each nominator shared how these recipients define exemplary work performance in these categories, This year, we are honored to present the 2019-2020 awards to the following recipients.
In the category of leadership, the nominator stated, the nominee has been a member of the Southwest family for over 5 years. In my opinion, she runs one of the most organized departments on campus and is very thorough in her work. She truly cares about her staff, considers them family, and encourages them to grow. In addition, I have seen her volunteer to help in any way possible, even if it's not an event she is organizing. An example would be the graduation pickup, when she stepped in to help distribute the signs to volunteers and help with the student check-in process when the line started getting longer. In addition, she is a staff advisor to the Women of Worth organization, and she is very intentional about meeting with her mentees and referring them to the resources if needed. She is overall very caring, whether she's talking to students, colleagues, and always has a listening ear. The 2019-2020 PESO Leadership Award is awarded to Ms. Shatika Ferris, Director of Testing.
In the category of service, the nominator stated, the employee exemplifies excellence in customer service. She is consistently courteous, helpful, accessible to students, faculty, and staff, and extremely knowledgeable. She follows through exceptionally well on helping students with their academic success and their needs. She is an excellent mediator and rarely has any of her cases escalate to the level of a complaint. In addition, she goes above and beyond what is asked of her on a daily basis, and she also proactively looks for ways to engage and support students above the standard practices of support. The nominee is an innovator and an excellent educator, both outside and inside the classroom. She is a role model, and she has even co-developed a reality check series to allow students to share their concerns as she teaches them excellent life skills and career development skills. She is an excellent communicator and often creates the most welcoming and caring atmosphere for students, faculty, staff, and community as she works collaboratively across the campus and across the city in serving students. I am so thankful to have her as a key part of the team. She works tirelessly to serve others and is authentic, offering her very best each and every day. The 2019-2020 PASO Service Award is awarded to Ms. Javonta Farmer, Program Specialist for Retention and Student Success.
Congratulations, and thank you both for the work that you do to assist the faculty, staff, and students every day. And to all those who are nominated, thank you as well. Southwest would not be where we are today without your hard work and dedication as we move forward.
We have faced unprecedented times in our world. Everyone was forced to make major adjustments to a new normal, including but not limited to within the arena of higher education.
At Southwest Tennessee Community College, this meant that we all needed to quickly and seamlessly reimagine the Southwest way.
The Professional Administrative Staff Organization thanks our administration for their leadership and tireless efforts during this challenging time. Today, we present a special leadership award.
Through collective efforts, this recipient has led Southwest through one of the greatest challenges in its 20 years of existence. Through her leadership during this crisis, we are building a stronger Southwest. In her words, Southwest continues to shine and show the world that we can adapt without compromising our commitment to quality. We can adjust without sacrificing our commitment to equity. We can improvise without abandoning our mission to achieve the dream of greater student success. We can move forward boldly without forsaking our compassion for those who experience acute challenges before, during, and after this crisis. We will get through, and we are leading through this. When COVID-19 fades, we will be here, teaching, serving, leading, and shining. It is with great pleasure and a warm thanks on behalf of the Professional and Administrative Staff Organization that we present this special award for leadership to our own Dr. Tracy D. Hall, President of Southwest Tennessee Community College.
Hello, everyone. It is a joy to be with you at this year's award ceremony. I miss seeing your smiling faces, hearing your laughter and your chatter. I especially miss my hugs. This year's Police Services Public Safety Awards will honor one member of the Southwest Emergency Response Team and one officer from our division. I'll start with the Southwest Emergency Response Team honoree. This honoree was one of the committee's first volunteers. This member is truly dedicated to your safety and security. This person takes every opportunity to receive additional training, regardless to whether it's on-site or off-site. This committee member also participates in each of our drills and exercises. The recipient of this award is a servant at heart and truly loves our school. It is with great pleasure to bestow the Award of Appreciation to Karen Campbell Taylor. The Director's Award of Excellence will honor an officer that works tirelessly on one of the most least desirable shifts, the 11 p.m. to 7 a.m. shift. He walks the halls of each building to ensure the campus is in a great state. He checks and double checks every crack and crevice and reports safety hazards as expeditiously as possible. He volunteers to assist when we have shift shortages and will contact me anytime, day or night, and I do mean anytime, day or night, to guarantee I've read his reports and received his emails of concern. He is a hard worker and has handled some very serious incidents. I'm so appreciative of everything our honoree has done to make our days safe. With heartfelt appreciation, the Director's Award of Excellence goes to Officer Orlando Cosby. Woo-hoo!
Hi, I'm Bill Summons, Faculty Senate President, and I'm here to award the 2020 Faculty Awards. Our first award is for Instruction and Curriculum Development. This educator was selected by TBR to serve on the statewide dual credit, that's SDC committee, to develop a high school business course for the state. As chair of this committee, her responsibilities included developing a crosswalk table, relating existing high school classes to the 83 learning objectives required for this high school course, creating detailed teacher training documents, and providing high caliber instructional training videos to participating schools. As a lead faculty in business and technologies, she developed the SWIFT course, which is BUSN 1360, Software Applications for Business. This year's award goes to Dr. Joan McCoy. Congratulations. Next up is service to the college. This educator has been the chair of the Faculty Handbook Committee and has served on the Faculty Welfare Committee. In 2019, he served as the local arrangements chairperson for the two-year College English Association of the Southeast when the national conference was held in Memphis. As well, during an average academic year, he spends around 380 hours serving as the chapter advisor for Sigma Kappa Delta, the English Honorary Society for two-year colleges. It's an honor and a privilege to award this to David Huffman. Congratulations. Next up is community service. In the past year, this instructor has been a board member of the Memphis Interdenominational Fellowship organization that focuses on child welfare and equitable access to educational opportunity. She serves on the Juvenile Detention Alternatives Initiative to combat racial and ethnic disparities that disadvantage youth of color, and is the faculty representative for the Choose Blue Day, which is a collaborative effort with the Memphis Police Department to recruit SCS students to the Police Service Technician Program. It's an honor to present this to Rosalind McGee. Congratulations. Our next award is in the category of leadership activities. This educator has demonstrated a commitment to serving our students, his colleagues, his department and division, and the college in many ways. At Southwest, he served as a Teaching Academy Fellow, where he helped create Winter Recharge, the spring semester kickoff event, is a division senator, and is the co-vice chair of the Equity and Inclusion Subcouncil. In the community, he serves as the marketing director for the Recorded Acapella Review Board. He's the executive producer of an international music compilation album, is a local theater director, and is the performance director for the award-winning Delta Capella Vocal Group. It's an honor to present this award to Thomas Leon King. Congratulations. Next up is our award for professional growth and development. This educator is a PhD candidate in electrical and computer engineering at the University of Memphis. He's reviewed more than 60 scholarly manuscripts and was awarded the distinction of being in the top 1% of reviewers in the world in his field in PubLons in 2018. Active in research, he's published more than 20 papers in the Institute of Electrical and Electronics Engineers International Journal, and has been cited 128 times according to Google Scholar. In 2018, he was elevated to the rank of senior member of IEEE, which is only bestowed upon 9% of that organization's membership. It's an honor to bestow this award to Salahuddin Muhammad Hussein. Congratulations.
Each year, the William W. Ferris Faculty Service Award is presented to the Southwest faculty member who best demonstrates a strong commitment to excellence in the teaching profession. The recipient is selected by a committee of their peers who deem this individual to possess all the attributes of an outstanding faculty member. This year's recipient is a dedicated scientist who ensures she keeps up with fast-paced changes in the field, often creating courses and making critical curriculum changes for her students. She maintains close relationships with numerous industries to confirm the college remains up to date and ensure her students are job ready when they graduate. She has received numerous awards throughout her career and served on the 2019 Science Panel and is a 2020 National Science Potential Panelist for Accelerating Research through International Network-to-Network Collaborations. This recipient of the Service to the College Award serves as the HIPPE Undergraduate Research Coordinator and as the coordinator for the Tennessee Lewis Stokes Alliance for Minority Participation. In addition, she has brought numerous grants to the college through her work with NSF and TBR. Her work with bringing science to the forefront really showcases her commitment to her students and her career. She created a special international studies class and took six students to Peru where they studied and cataloged more than 100 plants and animals of Cusco and Lima. She also created the AAS Biotechnology Forensic Science Technician Program, which broadened the course offerings for Southwest students and provided forensic investigative community with well-trained technicians. Today, we recognize this outstanding member of the faculty because of her tireless dedication to instruction, her service to the college, her commitment to professional development, and her leadership both within the college and the community. On behalf of my family, I'm honored to make this presentation to the 2019-2020 William W. Ferris Faculty Service Award recipient, Dr. Julianne Waits. And here is her plaque, and wish I could see her personally to give this to her, but congratulations.
Good afternoon, Salukis. I have two recipients of the Chief Information Award of Excellence. The first recipient has been with the college over 20 years. This person is willing to serve in any capacity. This person exhibits a positive attitude toward her fellow employees, faculty, staff, and students. She takes time to initiate and research and develop effective ways of performing her job duties. She serves as a manager when her supervisor is out. This person led the CASE project, which allows client services support the ability to image over 1,000 units at one time. This is very important when you're supporting over 5,000 units. Her supervisor wrote, "As a manager, I enjoy working with her. She always looks for ways to better things within our department that benefit the department as a whole. Her colleagues look to her for direction and leadership with dealing with complex matters inside and outside the department. She is the GOAT, which means the greatest of all times for the union team. Someone she supports wrote, "She is so patient with me anytime I ask for help. I can ask her the same question and she responds as if it's the first time I'm asking a question. She is caring and tries to teach me, but she is assisting me. I appreciate every interaction with her. My first recipient of the CIO Award of Excellence is Tanya Tillman." The second recipient has been with the college over 30 years. This person demonstrates on a daily basis selfless dedication and commitment to IT services as well as to faculty, staff, students at Southwest. This person has partnered with Academic Affairs to implement degree works at the college. She also partnered with Student Affairs to implement EAB Navigate. Both software implementations will help us more effectively and efficiently recruit, retain, and graduate students here at Southwest. Her supervisor wrote, "She is a compassionate professional and one of the finest leaders I had the pleasure of working with within my career. She is highly intelligent, passionate, kind, and committed to customer service. Southwest Tennessee Community College is lucky to have her as part of the family." Someone she partners with wrote, "She is a wonderful colleague and exemplifies the word excellence. She has worked tirelessly on major IT implementation projects such as Navigate and Saluki this year. As a college, we are truly blessed to have her leading or co-leading critical enterprise technology implementations. And we cannot thank her enough for all of her hard work for this past year, as well as for the new projects she will help lead to increase the data capacity at the college. She is reliable, hardworking, collaborative, responsive, as well as an expert in her field. In short, she is a gem." The second recipient of the CIO Award of Excellence is none other than Renee Hancock.
Warm greetings to my Saluki family as we gather virtually today to recognize some very important colleagues across our institution. I have been afforded the tremendous opportunity to lead and co-labor along some of the most dedicated, passionate, and hardworking professionals within the dynamic Division of Student Affairs. This annual event is one that I've come to look forward to because it allows a time of reflection on the accomplishments of the past academic year and gives me an opportunity to recognize the outstanding efforts of staff within our division who have performed above and beyond their call of duty. This award is given annually to two employees within the Division of Student Affairs and is accompanied by a personal gift from me. The person nominating this year's first recipient of the Vice President's Award had this to say about her. "She goes above and beyond in her position. Many times I have to email her with special exceptions for students. She does not hesitate to go out of her way to make sure our students can graduate. She is responsive almost immediately to emails and always has a solution, even in the most difficult situations. She is kind and does her job well. Two great qualities to have. I would like to personally add that in the course of her department going through leadership transition during a peak season for her unit, this young lady stepped up to the plate and led with dignity to ensure that our students were served well. In having a unique opportunity to work closely with her in the past several months, she lived out a quote that says, 'Leadership is not about your position. It is more about your passion for excellence and making a difference.' So today, we would like to honor a young professional who truly represents the ideals of the Vice President's Award of Excellence, none other than Ms. Mariah Brown. This year's second award winner was nominated by multiple people within the division, which speaks to her hard work ethic and collaborative spirit. One person nominating her said, "This is a very energetic young woman that makes multitasking look very easy. Any task that she is given is going to be done promptly, correctly, and organized. Another person said she works tirelessly each and every day to serve Southwest well. She manages a very large team of professionals, and her department is vitally essential to the overall success of the college. I appreciate all the ways in which she partners with various departments to problem solve in support of service to students. All nominators also praised her recent execution of events during the current pandemic that we are facing. Commencement is the hallmark event for academia, and as COVID-19 unexpectedly disrupted our planning for a traditional ceremony, we were charged with creating an experience for our students that honored their academic achievements. The superb execution of our curbside parade and virtual commencement could not have been possible without the long hours, passion, and untiring commitment to students that this year's award recipient always exhibits. It gives me great pleasure to present this year's Vice President's Award of Excellence to someone who truly reaches the apex of service, Dr. Nikita Ashford Ashworth. This year, we added a new category to our award slate. For the first time, we would like to introduce the Friend of Student Affairs Excellence in Partnership Award to recognize one individual outside of our division who consistently partners to help meet the mission and goals of student affairs. We could never be effective in our roles without the collaborative relationships that we have built throughout the organization. This award allows us to show appreciation to one of our other division friends. Evidence of the power of partnerships. I received several nominations from student affairs professionals for this award that represent that every division of our college partners with student affairs. The person nominating our winner had this to say: "This person has been an invaluable resource for the Division of Student Affairs. She has worked tirelessly to support our technical processes. Her commitment to Southwest shines through in the quality of her work, the level of leadership she provides to her team, and her resolute perseverance when we are faced with a difficult problem. In my opinion, one of her greatest qualities is her positive attitude. This enhances her ability to collaborate effortlessly with an array of individuals. While many do not make the connection because IT is often seen as a behind-the-scenes department, the work she does directly impacts the student experience. That is why we're all here, and that is why her hard work deserves recognition. I could not agree more. There is rarely a week that passes that I don't hear her name in support of efforts that are happening within student affairs, whether a technology implementation, system updates, or even working on means to create greater efficiencies for our students. So today, it is my distinct pleasure to award the Friend of Student Affairs Excellence in Partnership Award to Ms. Renee Hancock for her dedicated service to the college, but most importantly, her tireless collaboration within the Division of Student Affairs. Thank you.
This year's Service Award winner in Finance Administration is Sandra Wallace. While Sandra was recently promoted to Executive Director of Fiscal Operations, she continues to support the college in the role of Director of Cashiering. In that capacity, Sandra has worked very hard to enhance the student experience, collaborate with other departments and divisions, and improve understanding of complex business rules and leverage technology. She did all of this while joining Southwest in only 2 years. I hired Sandra, and in my first interview with her, I thought she'd be great at Southwest, and she's done just that. Sandra has worked well with students, engaging them, understanding their situation, being flexible while following college policies and procedures, and providing them with a laugh at times when sometime it was certainly needed. This year, Sandra's accomplishments include the following: leading the successful transition of all cashiering and accounts receiving to an online environment during the COVID-19 transition. She also came into the office, collected mail, processed, checked, and handled other duties while we're in COVID-19 during the transition. She led the CARES Act and the student implementation process, which was very complex
fast and evolving. She led an implementation of the electronic refunds process for students that receive aid, ensuring that they get funds in a faster and more reliable fashion. She worked hard and collaboratively with financial aid to develop better business processes between the two organizations. She assisted in two audits, the college's financial audit and then a voluntary financial aid audit. And lastly, and probably the most fun part of her job, she spent many hours answering questions from management, primarily me. Sandra did all this with a good attitude, of course, and worked very hard. For that, Finance Administration is awarding Sandra Wallace the FY20 Financial and Administration Service Award. Congratulations, Sandra.
Hello, I'm Cynthia Graham, Vice President of External Relations at Southwest. Today I'm here to announce our External Relations Outstanding Staff Member. It's my privilege to announce Rose Landy as the External Relations Outstanding Staff Member. With a great smile, Rose engages donors, students, faculty, staff, and pushes the mission of Southwest. She has worked at Southwest for over a decade and provides great leadership as the Executive Director of Institutional Advancement. During her tenure, Southwest has received more than $30 million in grant funding. She's been instrumental in a range of funding and community-related initiatives, from our beautiful new academic facilities to providing student scholarships. Rose is an asset to External Relations, Southwest, and the greater Memphis community.
Good morning, Southwest. My name is Dr. Kendricks Hooker, Vice President of Academic Affairs, and I am truly honored to be a part of such a special occasion. Anytime there's an opportunity to shine a spotlight on pivotal moments in an institution's trajectory, and everyone's responsible for that success, I count it a blessing. Today, that spotlight shines on digital learning and teaching academy teams, who provided the necessary support and training needed to create a relatively seamless transition to an online environment for our students during one of the worst national calamities in American history. Mere words cannot express my appreciation for you and your expertise. To say the least, you all knocked it out the park, and your tireless efforts did not go unnoticed. Additionally, I would be remiss if I did not take a moment to also recognize the entire Southwest faculty and staff for the hard work and dedication you all demonstrated as well during our nation's COVID-19 crisis that shifted Southwest to a virtual online world seemingly overnight. Your contributions are duly noted and held in the highest regard, not only by me, but many Southwest students who expressed their gratitude for your efforts. So faculty and staff, it is with gratitude that I say thank you, thank you, thank you for all that you do to positively impact Southwest and the student experience. And now, without further ado, I am beyond excited and truly honored to present the Academic Affairs Award to the entire Digital Learning and Teaching Academy teams. You all earned it, and congratulations to each of you for a job well done. Thank you.
Yeah, how about a big hand for everybody? All of our recipients, all of our honorees, everyone who took away something from the big Southwest Tennessee Community College. All right, Stan Bell, you know, it's a celebration. That's why I got this music on. Listen to this a little bit. Are we celebrating? All right. This is what I want to do right now before we have our very special Service and Retirement Honoree Award. This is what I want to do right now. I want to shout out a big roll call to those who were presenters. You just saw them. They did an excellent, fantastic job. Another round of applause for our presenters. Woo! All right, check it out. The roll call, Bridget Johnson, fantastic, BJ. Katrina Muldrow, Rhonda Warren, of course. Dr. Benita Boone, Dr. Boone, much love to you. I know you're in the room, Dr. Boone. Hey, that rhymes. I know you're in the room, Dr. Boone. I'm a poet and don't know it. Wow. All right, big shout out to L. Angela Webb, William Summons, John Ferris. Big shout out to Michael Boyd, Jacqueline Faulkner. I believe that's Dr. Hall's right hand, right? Hey, Dr. All right. Michael Neal, Cynthia Graham, Dr. Kendricks Hooker in the building. representing the Magnolia State, right? And congratulations on coming on in official, Dr. Hooker, man. That's the way you do it. And to all of the new or interim employees of Southwest Tennessee Community College, let me just say congratulations on a job well done. And you know, as I think about it, no one hates a job well done. That's what's up. And while I've got the microphone, and you know how I like to talk sometimes, but I do want to send my sincerest condolences to Miss Sandra Wallace. Sandra Wallace, our condolences, our thoughts and prayers with you in the passing of the transitioning of your wonderful and loving father. So our condolences, our prayers are with you right now. This is the virtual live ceremony. We are recognizing those who have worked hard, diligent, longevity, as Dr. King says, has its place. So without any further ado, I'm going to kick off what we call the service and retirement honorees. And we got some names. I'm just excited to shout them out at this time. Yep. If you're ready, say yay. Let's show those names right now. All right, congratulations to our five-year 2019-2020 Employee Service Award recipients. Evelyn Hamilton, Aisha Huck, Akwasi Kusi Apia, Barbara Lloyd, Tracy McLaughlin, Umpy Nelson, Alvin Norfleet, Carolyn Norfleet, Alan Otts, Christopher Rogers, Kenneth Rohn, Forrest Smith, Kiwana Smith, Tawana Smith, and Priscilla Thompson in the house. Those are the 5 years. Now, let's move on to 10-year 2019-2020 Service Award recipients. Are you ready to say yeah? Anthony Biggers, Robert Bladow, yep, Michael Boyd, John Foy, Rose Guy, Masume Hashduran, Karen Pierce, Ronald Ross, Larry Seiler, John Tyler Stevenson, Shirley Stewart, Emily Taylor, Brenda Teague, and Robert Walker. 15-year 2019-20 Service Award recipients. And you ready? I know you are. Show me those names. John, that's J-O-N, Clark, Brandon Eason, Lamicia Good Freeman, Joyce, J.J. Johnson, Joan McGrory, Katrina Muldrow, Rosie Taylor, Norma Terry, Amy Waddell, and Elizabeth Weaver. Hey, but it gets greater later. 20 years, Service Award recipients. Here they are. Vicky Armstrong, Douglas Branch, Ayana Churchill, Victoria Gray, Salathiel Holiday, Yvonne Martin, Megan Murphy, Shirley Oliver, Mickey Richardson, Twyla Waters, and Willie W.W. Wilson in the building. Let's move on up 25 years. Woo, that's a long time. That's older than Shelby State and State Tech. 25 years, Leslie McKnight, the great Charles Pender, Amy Sheed, Carl Swoboda, and Carol Tyler in the building. It's the roll call, 30-year Service Award recipients. Show me those names. Here we go. Ladies and gentlemen, let's congratulate Miranda Bolden, Gwen Hutton, and Tammy Murphy. That's three the hard way, everybody. Woo, give them a hand. But wait, it gets greater later. 35 years, woo, Service Award recipients. And the honorees are Charles Bryant, Jacqueline Hale, Deidre Tillman, three the hard way again. Woo! But wait, there's more. Somebody shout, 40. Woo, I heard you. 40 years, hard work. Here we go. First, Bernice Neal. That's it. Just one name, one and only, Bernice Neal. Yep, she's in a class by herself. Bernice Neal, congratulations. All right, so all the retirees, Southwest Tennessee Community College, we salute you. I just want to say congratulations on a job well done. And you know, as I think about it, no one hates a job well done. Now, who do we have here? These are retirees? Woo! Dwayne Benson, Annie Garvin, Lafayette Gatewood, Deborah Hanna, Bobby Hawkins, Mechuen Sia, Yolanda Johnson, Lachelle McCarley, Janetta Moore, Janice Morganfield, Carolyn Qualls, Donna Reed Mathena, James Russell, Leslie Taylor. How about it for Joyce Tillis, Kenneth Vanderpool, Clemente Whaley, and last but certainly not least, Ruby Wilburn in the building. Our retirees, Southwest Tennessee Community College. Ooh, I'm back on. Let's give them a big hand. Let me say something about that. You know, it was
I want to thank you for your service, and I want to thank you for your hard work, and those of you who are retired. Let me say, it was Marion Wright Elliman. She is the president of the Children's Defense Fund. She said it best, service is the rent we pay for living, not something we should do in our spare time. Let me say that again. Service is the rent we pay for living, and not something we should do in our spare time. So I congratulate you on a job well done. And that's what it is. And those of you who have reached that milestone of retirement, this is what you ought to be shouting right now. Goodbye, tension. Hello, pension. How about that? You'll get that on the way home. Okay, that's all right. Yeah, you'll get it. That's right. No more tension, but say hello to that check and that pension. All right, y'all. So this is what I want to say to you all. Keep up the good work. God bless you in your endeavors. In trying times, don't quit trying. When things go wrong, as they sometimes will, when the road to trudging seems all uphill, when the funds are low and the debts are high and you want to smile, but you have to sigh, when cares are pressing you down a bit, rest if you must, but don't you quit. Congratulations. Now, we've got some really special after the president comes back and makes a closing remarks and talks about how wonderful these recipients are. We're going to have a very special making of video. Hint, hint, outtakes, bloopers, and all of that. So I want everybody, don't leave the room when Dr. Hall finishes her address and her closing remarks and announcements, because we got something really special. So let me say again, thank you for allowing me to be your master of ceremony, your MC, your agenda guide, your program navigator, and your DJ, the bell ringer. Thank you so much. So with that being said, I want to thank V2 Media behind the scenes for putting it together production-wise, and the wonderful staff, Mark Thompson and his wonderful staff, for what you've seen on this virtual video, this virtual ceremony live in the house. Yeah, digital round of applause. All right, now make it live. Okay. So with that being said, let's now kick it back to our illustrious president of the Southwest Tennessee Community College, the one and only Dr. Tracy D. Hall, with remarks.
Each year, it is my honor and privilege to recognize a faculty or staff member who has impacted our students and/or the Mid-South community in a profound manner. This year's honoree leads a service center where entrepreneurs are born and nurtured, where dreams of business ownership are brought into crystal clear focus and marshaled into reality. A center where grit and know-how meet and produce outcomes that not only profoundly change a person's life, but also add to our city's workforce and tax base. The place I speak of is the Tennessee Small Business Development Center at Southwest Tennessee Community College. And our award recipient is its modest, yet keenly knowledgeable, influential, and capable leader, Mr. Rory Thomas. Mr. Thomas is a beacon in the Memphis community. He is known and highly regarded in our city's most important workforce development circles, including the Memphis Regional Chamber. He also is well respected across the state of Tennessee for his outstanding achievements in small business development. In 2014, only 1 year after his arrival, the Tennessee Small Business Development Center Network bestowed upon Mr. Thomas the 2014 State Star Award. This annual honor recognizes a top performer from each state SBDC network who demonstrates a strong commitment to small business and makes significant contributions to the state network. Mr. Thomas has only grown in his accomplishments since that award, representing Southwest in excellent fashion in workforce development circles and in the media. He is a consummate professional and seminal thought leader for small business and economic development. Ladies and gentlemen, it gives me great pleasure to announce Mr. Rory Thomas, Executive Director of the Tennessee Small Business Development Center, as our 2020 Presidential Award recipient. Congratulations, Mr. Thomas. You are most deserving of this honor, and I look forward to one day presenting your award to you in person. Until then, thank you for all you do for Southwest and the Mid-South community.
Thank you for joining us for this special occasion. Thank you to the members of our Human Resources Division for making this virtual event a reality. Special thanks to Ms. Loretta Bartlett for her leadership in coordinating this celebration. Great job. And to our Years of Service and Service Excellence honorees, congratulations again. I am truly grateful to each and every employee for their courage and commitment to this past year as we reimagine Southwest. We are who we are because of you. We are Southwest. Thank you and be well.
Yahoo! I love this celebration. We have been celebrating so much, I just don't know what to do. It's party time. It's Friday. It's a beautiful Friday. I want you to have a beautiful weekend. Let me thank Dr. Tracy D. Hall. I don't know if that D stands for Delta or what. But Dr. Hall in the building. My girl, you're doing a great job at the helm. Congratulations. And please stay with us because we see the growth. We see your vision. And it's all being executed. So thank you so much. Again, congratulations. That merger of Shelby State Community College, merging with State Technical Institute at Memphis, now becoming Southwest Tennessee Community College. 20 years. That's a celebration. It's a celebration for sure. All right. So that's what I was saying. So a big shout out to Dr. Burks. Much love to you. I call him Dr. Osgood. Dr. Oz, I call him. Thank you so much for always supporting us and being on the case. And thank you to everybody. Southwest Tennessee Community College, celebrating a generation of dreams. Woo! All right, now it's time for that very special making of, as we told you about. I think you're going to like this one. You've seen a lot of making ofs of videos, a lot of making of certain things, but this is the one you want to stay in the room for. So make sure you check it out, all right? Congratulations, everyone. And don't move. We're going to show the outtakes and the bloopers and have a little fun. Have a great weekend.
Courage and commitment to... Tongue got in the way.
I'm a math teacher. Oh,
okay. 2 plus 2. All right, we're rolling.
One that I have come to look forward to. Sorry.
Through her leadership. Oh, stop. Okay.
And we're rolling.
Hi, I'm Katrina Muldrow, president of PASO.
Then you gotta move. Oh. That's okay, take 2.
And provides great leadership to the executive, blah, blah, blah. Sorry.
We're gonna use that. Blah, blah, blah.
Volunteers. And I messed up.
So good. Eat and produce outcomes that no. Hate when I do that.
Following critic.
We receive numerous.
Okay, no, that was good.
Okay.
And a special leadership award.
Announce Rose Landry. I did it again.
Without the collaborative relationship,
sorry guys.
Into click. Oh, I can't believe it.
That's all we can do.
That's all I can do. I do the best I can.
We are rolling.
West shines through in the
recipients defined. These recipients defined
exemplary. Okay.
Miss Shatika Ferris, Director of Testing.